This is your one and only Firespark 81 with your daily dose of video goodness. We are back with episode 3 of Building Vertical, and today we are gonna finish this treehouse one way or another. Alright, let's get to it. I went ahead and I placed a wall, this part here, so you guys could see. We did not do this last time, so I just want to make sure that is noted. I placed this. I had to build a little bit because it's been a while since I've built the other treehouse, and I had to refresh my memory, and I went ahead and just left this wall up here to save time, plus to show you guys part of what the finished product will look like. So we're gonna go ahead and do that to this side as well. So we'll start with these first, and then we'll get to finishing the roofing part. And that's a great way to start. Let's get this placed in the right way. There we go. So all you're going to do is just build straight across. And you may have to, as you saw there, you may have to mess with it a little bit because we do have some intersecting ceiling pieces. So it may not want to go straight. And then you're going to leave your gaps because you're going to, your angled gaps, because you're going to fill those in with slope pieces. This seals everything off nice and neat. And I did have a viewer mention to me that I should do a PvP build, that a lot of people would find that interesting. This whole design here can be PvP. All you'd simply have to do is build the whole thing out of metal. Don't leave your open section here. And I will show you when we're all done how you can get a 360 degree view and attack from any angle from that 360 using the doors to create windows like we did in the finished build of the other one. So I will show you guys that, and I will show you a finished metal build as well, just to show you that this whole thing can be built in metal and be used for PvP if that's what you wish. My main goal here was to create a treehouse which no one could get into unless you let them into, and that is my main goal for all of these treehouse builds. So any of these, just because I'm building them out of wood does not mean that they can't be built out of metal and used for PvP. I just like the way wood looks, so that's why I build out of wood. I think the giant metal structures hanging in these trees out here is just horrible, but that's me. So you're gonna have to delete this first row of roofing here, because otherwise it won't let you place your slope roofs. It tells you that they're obstructed. So you're gonna remove those. And of course that's the wrong way. Just, we're having those issues today. Are we the right way? Yes, there we go, okay. So you're just going to place your slopes like that, and this is going to allow you to completely square off that section. So, and then we're going to have to put our, what's this, slope roofs back. So let's get our slope roofs. Now we're going to build the wall up from the bottom and level it off with the top here as well. Okay, so for finishing off the roof, and before I get into finishing off the roof, I want to make sure I let you guys know. Over there, down in the bottom earlier, actually I think it was last episode, we went ahead and put in, we deleted some of the ceiling and put in a ramp to get to the second floor. I'm going to advise to fill that hole back over until you're done. I kept running into issues where it was telling me that I didn't have foundation support. So what I did is I just put the ceiling back over that hole that we had created for a ramp up, and all those issues went away. So wait until you're all done and then delete those ceiling pieces. I don't understand why it does it that way, because you would think that if it didn't have, if that removed the foundation support, then parts of your ceiling and your roof would be destroyed when you removed part of the floor, but it doesn't. So just make sure you leave this whole ring all done until you're completely finished building, and then go through and start deleting pieces. Okay, so now we're gonna get just plain old ceiling, and we're gonna snap a piece straight on here like this. And then we're going to snap a piece to it like this. And then you should get another one that angles like that. And then you're gonna do the same thing all the way across. And then when, oh, we missed some roofing pieces. Let's fill that back in real quick. Then when you get to your other side, you're gonna do the same thing and just square it off like that. Okay, now we're gonna go through and we're gonna place ramps. Not slope roofs, ramps. And you're gonna wanna place it, come on, right in the middle of each of these, and it's gonna fight you, but it will place just like that. So basically the middle of your ramp is gonna line up with your middle roof area, or the middle of your roof area right here. So we'll go through and we'll do it again like that. And like I said, it can be tricky. Just kind of look around and it will eventually snap right to where you need it. Okay, so now once you have all of that done, what you're gonna do, and I kind of like this look because, and with these, because it kind of reminds me of like air vents. Use your ramp and it should snap right like that. Now this is gonna block off this hole here and once again make the base impenetrable. Because this can, like I said, this can be used as PvP once it's all completed, and it can be metal. And I think what I'm gonna do after the at the end of the video is show a speed build of just me replacing all of the wood with metal pieces. So stay tuned to the very end of the video if you wanna see that. I'll play some music and there won't be any commentary, it'll just be a straight speed build showing you guys that it can all be in metal. Okay, so if you run into an issue where it's obstructed, let me show you the issue that I was having here. I have this set up like this, same way all the way around like I just showed you, but now I'm running into a problem that's telling me that the ramp is obstructed. Delete the one that lays underneath of it. Place your vent, we're gonna call these these ones right here the vent ones. Place your vent one and then place your bottom one back. Okay, now that we have all of that, we are only left with these gaps here and our center ring. Filling in these gaps is pretty simple. You're going to grab your slope roof and it should snap right in there. Maybe. It did it before. It will snap. There. Snaps right in there like that. Then we'll replace our ramp. Bam. And no one can get in. It's completely sealed off. It looks great. And now we're just going to do the same thing to this side. So we'll delete our ramp, place a sloped roof, put our ramp back. Come on, ramp. There we go. Completely sealed off. No one can get in. I mean, they may be able to see in just a tiny bit in some certain areas, but they're not getting in, and I really doubt they're going to be able to shoot in. And you have this nice ramp at the top which on the other one, I put the giant ballistas here and there, just because I thought they looked cool. Okay, let's get to this inner ring. Now that we've got all the finishing touches on the roof and we have the side pieces and it's all squared off nice and gorgeous like, we are going to fill in the gap areas here to finish it off and make it impossible for anybody to get in. There are two options to do this. You can either wall it off so that you just have a gap inside your tree. Now, this option here would be more advised for PvE because you could get people in here, stuck in here, and it would be hard to get to them. Also, it leaves gaps, which is big enough that I'm pretty sure someone could shoot in. But yeah, there we go. So this probably wouldn't be the best design for PvP, but for PvE, this would be fine if you don't mind the little gap there and you like the way it looks. The other option is to remove this wall here that we placed. It will not destroy your top there, and if it does, you can just rebuild it back and it will stay without the wall as you see here. The trick to doing this, and of course I still have metal structures on me, so let me go down here and grab the wood stuff. Okay, now that we have what we need, you're going to need your fence foundation, and what you're going to do is right here, if you built it right, there should be two pillars. And you can see the same thing on this side. There's two pillars right by that wall. What you need to do is get the fence foundation to go like that and stick out. And then if you angle it just right, you may have to look around a little bit. You should be able to get another one like that and have this V shape. Now, you want to place wall all the way up like that, and then again, now we're stuck. That just goes to show that you cannot get through that once it's been placed. So now we're going to do it again for this wall. And then when you get to the top, you're going to want to put an angled piece just like that, and then we'll put our last piece of our thing and another angled piece, and that blocks this whole section off and nobody can fit through it. And because it's two pieces and they're angled, it'd be almost impossible for anybody to shoot through. See, the tree's just going to keep getting in the way, and nobody should be able to shoot through that. They can't fit through it. I mean, you could see through it a little bit, but who cares? You can't get through there at all. It's completely blocked off. So once again, those are your two options for sealing this section off. If you use the wall method, like we have here, you don't need to ramp like we did on the other levels. However, if you use the V method to block off that little area, you need to go through and do the ramps like we did on the bottom section. They'll place right across the top without any issues at all. And then if you want, you can also place them in this section here to separate the two floors here. I like leaving it open. It gives it more of an open feel between these two floors, but you don't have to. You can also drop down easy if you're up doing whatever in the attic. You could use it for storage or what have you. You can just drop down really easy back down to this floor and then head back down. So I like leaving this open, but you don't have to. You can fill in each of these levels with the ramps like we did here. You could do the top and the middle as well. I also want to show you, you can remove this floor now to open your ramp back up, and you can hear nothing above it got destroyed. I'm going to do this one too. There we go. Now we have our ramp back downstairs. And then to get to the ceiling, all you have to do is make a hatch. So wherever you want your hatch to be, see, it'll snap to a bunch of different locations in here. But you got to be careful, because sometimes where these intersect, your hatch won't be fully open. So you have to put it in like one of these places right here. See? It won't work here because you're overlapped. It won't work here because you're overlapped. Pretty much the only place you're going to be able to place it is in the middle, but you can place it either on this side or on this side. It doesn't matter. And then you place it, and there you go. You have your hatch, and you can go down, place a little ladder there or whatever else you want to place there. All right, well, it was a long journey. And it was a pain in the ass at times, but we have this awesome treehouse built and it is done. So if you want to see more of the metal version, stick around and I will have that at the very end of the video and you can check that out. If you like this video, leave a comment down below. Let me know what you thought. If you didn't like it, leave a comment down below. Let me know what you thought. If you're shy and you don't like to comment, just hit that thumbs up button and show your support. Until next time, thanks for watching.